Hey, Matt 31, I had a question coming out of section 7.2, number 21. And here we were given a 3x3 system. All right, three variables, three equations. And my game plan is always to reduce it to a 2x2. All right, so what I'm going to take a look at is the coefficients. And if you can see the x coefficients, they're 2, negative 3, and negative 1. And because I have that negative 1, I'm going to keep that in mind for eliminating x's. When I see the y's, they're 3, 2, and 5. There's not a 1 in there, so I'm not really thinking I'm going to use the y's to eliminate. I see the z's as negative 4, positive 1, and positive 3. So right now, because I have a positive 1 coefficient and a negative 1 coefficient, those are the two variables I would opt to eliminate. I would throw y out. And I'm just, for personal preference, I'm going to eliminate z. You could just as easily eliminate x. But if I want to eliminate z, the nice thing about the first two equations is that they already have opposite signs. So what I want to do is multiply this second equation by 4. So here you see me writing the first equation. And now I'm multiplying the second equation by 4. And I'm going to distribute that 4 to every term in the equation. And when I do that, you can see that the z's, by design, eliminate, which is great. That's what you wanted. And now we're looking at our first 2x2. Well, not quite a 2x2, but I want to mention here, I only have two variables, right? Which is a good thing. We're eliminating variables. All right, well, now that I've paired the first and second equation, I'm going to go ahead and pair the first and third. But taking a look at it, they have the same signs in terms of their coefficients. So what I'm going to do here is not only multiply this equation by 3 so that I have that coefficient of 3, but I'm going to multiply it by negative 3 so that they have opposite signs. And that's what you see me doing here, multiplying the second equation by negative 3 and just keeping the third equation. And again, when we multiply all of that out, and let me just do one little reminder, make sure you distribute to all of the terms. A lot of times we forget to distribute to the term on the right, or I'll say at least I do. So it's something I try and remember. The z's eliminate by design, and all of a sudden I've got, again, another equation with only two variables in it, which is great. So I've got my new 2x2, right? And at this point, it's a matter of eliminating another variable. And let's take a look. Let's play the coefficient game again. So I got negative 10 and positive 8. Those are not fun. All right, but I've got here positive 11 and negative 1. I say winner, winner, chicken dinner, right? Even though I'm vegan. So the reason I'm going to pick the y's is because the coefficient is 1 and their signs are opposite. So all I need to do here is multiply everything by 11. And that's what I'm doing at this step here, right? And I'm going to distribute. And then by design, the y's eliminate and x is this delightful, delightful fraction. Okay, it's negative 45 thirteenths. Do I wish it was a whole number? Yeah. But can I still work it even without? Absolutely. So now it's time to back sub. So I'm going to take that negative 45 thirteenths and I'm going to put it in here. You could also have opted to put it into this equation. I'm just choosing this second equation only because the numbers are nicer. All right. So I sub that in, solve for y, and y is also a delightful, delightful fraction. Okay. Once you have these two, so you see I have the x and I have the y, we're going to now go all the way back to the originals, the original equations, and sub x and y into any set here. I don't care which one it is, but it'll allow you to solve for z. I opted for, let's see, I have negative 3x plus 2y plus z equals 11. So which one did I ultimately choose? It looks like I went with equation 2. Not sure why. Oh, I know why I did it, because I would directly solve for z. Okay. All right. So moving along there, I find out z is negative 2. Great. We actually have a whole number. Fantastic. So there is my ordered triple. Now, I always say you should check your answers. And when I say check your answers, especially when I have fractions, I'm going to take this x value, this y value, and this z value, and I'm going to plug it in to all three equations and see if equality holds. All right. Let me write equality holds. And I would use my calculator and the store function to do this. But if equality holds on all three of these, you know you've got the right answer. There's no question at that point. All right. All right. Thanks so much, everyone. Bye.